all my years and believe in you, but I just can't get no relief, Lord. Somebody, ooh, somebody, can anybody find me somebody to love? Yeah. I work,
he works hard
every day of my life. I work till I ache my bones at the end.
At the end of the day,
I take home my heart on me. All of my own is tired out. My knees and eyes straight away till the tears run down from my eyes.
Oh,
somebody,
somebody,
ooh, somebody.
Thank you. All right. Where was I? Marriage. Marriage is what brings us together. All right. In all seriousness, you have been invited to witness the birth of new love in his life. Like I was saying, there was not a time long ago that younger versions of these two would have passionately argued against the possibility of who they are today. Today they would say that they would have been much more attractive, they would have been much better shape, maybe on tour, maybe six figures. And many of us here today can relate to such a sentiment. We just don't know what the goodness of the future has in store. Being able to predict the future is not a strength or of our human nature, and being alone isn't strength for most of us either. See, we were designed for deep and meaningful relationships. Life without relationship with someone who understands and cares for us deeply leaves us to the possibilities of loneliness and isolation. We all enter this life with immediate need for this care and consideration. And although many of our experiences may vary, we were given a starter relationship at birth. Depending on our parents, we get our first lessons of what love is. We then might develop some complex relationships with our siblings, we form friendships and not-so-friendly ships, and all of us in one way or another have spent our entire lives navigating the treacherous and very worthwhile paths of relationship, whether it be shallow or very deep. Somehow we learn to love. Whether it be something we excel in or lack in general, we each have a capacity for love. These relationships that you have with your family have value. The more we mutually pour our efforts into one another, the more invested in those relationships we become. And stronger our connections grow. Regardless of who's involved, the journey of each relationship is important. Relationships carry us from one season of life to the next, as transitions providing its own beginning and end. And each relationship provides a grief that desperately misses that what was, what could have been. The end of relationship brings a death of sorts. The beginning of a new loving relationship being the birth of a new life. The end of each relationship providing grief and the death of sorts. Acknowledging these observations suggests that we should never overlook or take for granted the celebration of life, love, and death. We should hope to find ourselves in our late years with nostalgic memories of good people and heartfelt moments, such as this. We celebrate these moments because there's a great strength in those that put effort into living life well with others. With friends and family that share the deepness of life with you and not apart from you. We are wise to deeply care for one. We are wise to do relationship well. Raychel, I struggled to find a better word for you, but all I could gather is sparring. The mace has told me that there are more endearing traits that you bear than it says that you are a beacon of light amidst a dark world. Your presence is very meaningful to him and to others. Your consideration for the people around you is appreciated and remained. Who you are is what makes this day special. Nathan, you know how I feel about you. But we can hash that out some other time. More importantly, Raychel finds a sanctuary confidence. You are a provision of joy and rest for her. The strong and driven lady needs a man that can dream big and provide her rest in the storms of life. And she says that she has found that. You are a faithful source of support and hope. You are an encouraging character and appreciated in love. You are what makes this day special. The It's in this very relationship that you both have found something significant. You found approval from one another to endure hardship, to share the joy of life together, rather than separating from commitment and the assurance of faithfulness. You have found each other to be worthy of such an amazing relationship, but also the honor of commitment, selfless sacrifice, and the promise of marriage that provides for both. Marriage between a lifelong unity of souls. Two becoming one in the presence of God. Your relationship with each other is now part of your relationship with God. You have both requested the perfect communion with one another as a symbol of your commitment and union with God. Communion is a relationship that has had with great meaning and intention. As you both exchange thoughts, words, and heartfelt feelings with one another and experience, you do so with God being your provider. I ask everyone to please remain quiet, respectfully, as Nathan and Raychel partake in communion. So if you take a break from looking at each other, you weren't looking at each other. That really was dependent upon that. And you take a look at the people before you who made good on their word to come today and listen to us hammer on, but who are specifically here for you. These are the people that are here to celebrate with you on this tremendous occasion. This is your community. These are your loved ones. With that said, we are gathered here today in the sight of God in heaven, amongst the presence of your family and community, celebrating one of life's greatest moments, to give recognition to the worth and recognition, and to add our best wishes and blessings to the words which shall unite Nathan Champneys and Raychel Elizabeth Feller and holy matrimony. This marriage is to be the most honorable condition created and instituted by God, signifying to us a union which rests between Christ and the community of the church. So too, may this marriage be adorned with true and abiding love. Nathan, please take Rachel's ring. Place it on her hand. Nathan, do you take Rachel to be your wife? You promise to love, honor, and cherish, and protect her, forsaking all others, holding only to her for a moment. Rachel, please take Nathan's ring. Place it on your hand. Rachel, do you take Nathan to be your forever husband? Do you promise to love, honor, cherish, and protect him, forsaking all others and holding on to him forevermore? Nathan, Rachel, insomuch as the two of you have agreed to live together in this holy union, may you strive to not only uphold it, but to celebrate it each day in the name of the love of Jesus for one another. You have promised for your love for each other by these vows, the giving of these rings and the joining of your hands. I now declare you husband. Congratulations. You may kiss the bride. Champneys.
Neither were willing.